Kia ora, everybody, and welcome along to the Franklin Pool and Leisure Centre. It is time for the Bulls to host the Tauranga Whai in the penultimate game of round five. Just 33% from beyond the arc. Luther Ahmed gives it back to Josh Scott. Eight to shoot, still plenty of time. Another catch inside for Timmins. Timmins gets the and one. Sam Timmins feasting at the moment down low.
He's just way too big for Jaden Bazant. That is a mismatch if I've ever seen one. Bazant does well to catch him early and force him to put it on the ground, but when help doesn't come, it's just too physical, too easy.
Holland operating with Jackson Jr. up high. Rasmatch right there. Steele, Muhammad. And the layup is nice. The Bulls racing out to a 7-3 lead.
Easy as you like. Knows exactly what he's doing. Nice kick ahead by Brantley. After the nice defense by Russ Bashford.
Piero Hunt knocking that down.
And that's the most as aggressive he's been with the ball in hand. I think he's going to have to take those shots that are half open, especially from the three-point line.
Boucher, Jaden Boucher. Just to save it without picking up a foul there. DKP knocks it away. Streaks down the other end. And gets the layup. Full court for DKP, not like 3x3.
Doesn't love the run, but he likes the buckets. He gets his hand on a couple of balls and eventually rewarded after that activity in the passing lane.
Lead is nine for the Bulls. Piero Hunt going at DKP, who gets the block. He tells him about it as well. One of the one-on-one move by Piero Hunt.
It's just fantastic to see DKP where he's at right now. Don Kamopoto.
Luther Muhammad crossing half court. Carl with the pickup. DKP feeling it. Knocking that down. Dom Kalman-Poto for three.
Inside, outside. I mean, every team player on this squad is capable of hitting that three. DKP shows it's the bigs as well.
Nice Jackson Jr. knocking down another three.
The Bulls not reading the scout.
He's 5 of 6 now. He's 3 for 3 from downtown. He's got 13. It's Bazant, 10 to go. Jackson Jr. has been a weapon for them offensively. That is a tough shot. Timmons got his hands on the ring there, but that wasn't called. As Muhammad fires it out, Davidson for three. That's good, Isaac Davidson knocking down that triple.
And Bulls fans say, finally. You know that free slice is coming. That's when you make all the noise.
Timmons with Denham Brook on him, freshly in the game. Skip pass. Swings to Davidson. Timmons with the rebound. Goes at Denham Brook on the reverse. Making life tough down there are the fight at the moment for Sam Timmons. Oh, steal. Josh Scott, like a blur. To the cup and in.
He read that like a cheap book he picked up at the airport and was stuck in the courtroom lounge.
Muhammad operating with Timmons. Is Scott pulling up? That's nice from Josh Scott.
Finally took a jumper. Josh Scott has been avoiding scoring the basketball like he doesn't want to catch a cold or something, but with a jumper that pretty, maybe do it a few more times.
Lead back to 14. Bazant going to the left. Oh, nice finish from Jaden Bazant.
Well, lovely footwork in on Ethan Ruspatch there. Is that a foul on Jaden Bazant?
It is. Ethan Ruspatch with a vet move. I mean, that is, I'm going to give that to Dylan Boucher.
That is amazing. What is Jaden Bazant supposed to do?
Ethan Ruspatch sealed him off.
If we've got that again, I would just love to show that to every young player in the country about how Ethan Ruspatch just completely sets up Jaden Bazant here.
Watch him here.
He grabs the rebound and then boxes into him and somehow Bazant gets whistled for the foul.
Ruspatch has it blocked by Carr. Holland. Lewis for three. He's hit. As Ethan Ruspatch might have got hit as well.
As we take a look at the drive, Ruspatch probably wanted to drop this one off to DKP. Instead, he goes for it. And Carr says, no, no. And then on the break, comes up. Tough to see the contact from that angle there.
of this extra possession. They find Timmons down low. He puts it up and in. Sam Timmons wants the and one as well. Lead is now up to 16 with 2 minutes gone in this fourth quarter. Carr with four to shoot. Ah, buttery. The jumper is smooth from Phil Carr.
Up to 13 points now. When it looks good for him, it looks really good.
The long arms of Carr and Jackson Jr. Good defensive player in Holland. And in and out for Muhammad DKP.
Oh, saves it.
That is hustle personified. Kamal Toto saving it and putting it off the five player, and it will stay with the Bulls.
I think he's calling line.
I think that's what I heard.
Look at that. Look at that angle. DKP and Vance Jackson Jr. in your living room. Sorry about the sweat on the lounge seat.
Rush match. Davidson for three. That's good, Isaac Davidson knocking it down.
Yeah, it's been a while between drinks for the three-point shot.
Jackson Jr.
Make it five.
It's set to go down. Five now. Timeout. Sebastian Gleim and the Bulls calling it again. Hero Hunt kicking it out. Carr spinning.
Oh, my.
That counts. That Phil counts Carr.
And look at this little. Yeah, that's definitely a travel. The step. But then afterwards, the contact looked like it was well before the shot, but he's in the motion, so he gets the benefit of the doubt. Now look for the Bulls to try and execute a little bit sharper than they did last time.
Davidson with the rebound. Excuse me, the layup. And Matt Lacey, head coach of the Fire, calls time. And that's the game. It's an 11-point win for the Franklin Bulls. They survive. A good challenge by the Fire, but they just haven't been able to pull that double-digit lead in and hold on to a run. They get the job done to the Bulls. And the Fire, again, are held to 74 points after a loss to the Ayers earlier on in round five.